Good morning. Welcome to Dude RV. I appreciate you stopping by, and you got here just in time. Just in time for the 1 year review of Trudy Thunder, our Thor Magnitude Super C. Before we get too far into this 1 year Super C RV review video, I want to take a moment to tell you about Second Chance Canine Rescue. If you're not familiar with Second Chance Canine Rescue, their mission, and they're not sponsoring this, a subscriber reached out and brought it to my attention that they have a fundraiser in progress, and so I've watched, they have a YouTube channel, Second Chance Canine. Their mission is the veterans, both human and canine veterans. I was not aware of this, but most of your canine veterans are euthanized at the end of their service. And that's intolerable. They give their lives just as willingly as their human counterparts, and they should be treated with all due respect. Second Chance Canine's mission is to help both the human vet and the canine vet with the stresses that they're bringing home from their time in battle, the PTSD and all the stuff that goes along with war. War is not a pretty thing, and it does horrible things to the human psyche, and it does the same damage to the canine psyche as well. And Second Chance Canine Rescue, their mission is to help both humans and canine vets reacclimate to a life that doesn't involve war. I'd encourage you to visit the links in the description below. Let's help those vets. What can I say? I mean, they were willing to give their lives for us. Let's cough up a little bit for them. They deserve some respect and some help. All right, let's get back to the video. Trudy's an RB34, which means she has a bunkhouse. We've had her for a year. We're fortunate in that we've not had any real major issues, knock on wood. This past year has been relatively event-free as far as failures. Now, there have been some things that could have been done better and should have been attended to before we took possession of Trudy, but the dealership has done the best they could with parts availability, so I've had to make several trips down there for service. Most of that was not on them. Now, there was some inattentiveness, I'll say that, for a bit of time, but that's been sorted out too. As far as the motorhome itself, I'm not here to talk about the dealership. They are what they are. The motorhome. Let's start with the chassis. It was one of the primary decision points for us was this F550 Super Duty chassis. Love it. Hands down, best RV I've ever driven. Plenty of power. Fuel efficiency is great. I just had to buy an air filter. It's an interesting kind of air filter. It's got a pre-filter before the filter. And right now the only place you can buy one seems to be through Ford. It's like $65. Take a break. Yappy called. She's checking on me. While I was talking to her, I cleaned off the front window above the bunk. Love that thing. We just love that window. It brings in so much more light, and it gives us something else other than just the front bulkhead to look at. Talking about the chassis rock solid. We're at 12,000 miles. That's right. We've traveled 12,000 miles in the year since we've purchased this motor home. Quite a bit of travel. Average 10 to 11 miles per gallon. Pulling the full-size pickup a little bit higher, 12 or so when we don't have the load. I can't say enough good things about this chassis. It's great. Plenty of power and fuel efficient. You can't beat that in a motor home. Talk about the motor home. There haven't been a whole lot of, as I mentioned, there's not been a whole lot of major issues. We had a punch list of minor stuff. from when we first took ownership, and it's taken a year to get all of those parts and to get it all sorted out. I'll just go through and I'll identify most of the stuff that we've had worked on.
First one was, we haven't had this worked on yet, but the bumper's curling right there. It's a shroud over the OEM bumper, and that's a known issue with the Magnitudes and the Omnis. The first 9 months that I drove this thing, I kept hearing a rattling noise. And we emptied the cabinets, and for every trip I was looking for that. Turns out there's a brace, a strut under the running board that was added by, that running board is added by Thor. It was not anchored to the frame. Self-tapping screws took care of that. The driver's side, that same bracket failed and fell off, and I just had the dealership put it back on. We are equipped with the 360 siphon vent cap. They are not real strong. In both cases, we've lost the front one that you can see from here. We've lost that twice due to small tree branches, not big ones, just small tree branches like hanging over the edge, the end of the campsite. It popped it right off. The last time it happened, I got up there with some JB Weld, because it looks like those little discs just snap on the arms. But I put some JB Weld on there, and so far, crossing my fingers, we haven't had any issues with it. And one of the incidences where we, and this was driving down a state highway, and there was some tree branches that brushed against the side of the coach. They took off the 360 siphon, as well as the end piece for the awning. So that sticks out. Those are hanging points. A little bit of a problem. I did not care for this sink that was out here, because that sump pump to lift it to the water sits in there and it gets stagnant. So it's, I put the dog shower on. So now we can wash the dogs. I put a 5-foot hose on there. That's a lot more practical than having that little sink. We weren't using the refrigerator, and we already had the washing machine. So I took out the refrigerator and put in the washing machine. Yes, this model is washer dryer prepped. The closet in the master has plumbing for the washer dryer. We currently don't need that, but that option is available to us. I have a little dryer that I carry in the back of the truck if we're going on a long trip. The chassis tows this truck like it's not even back there. So that's a no-brainer. The little basket works great. You can see I'm carrying firewood. That way we don't get dirty inside. This side, the slide topper makes noise when the wind blows, but they all do. That is a tankless water heater. We don't care for it. Primarily because if you're dry camping and you're not connected to a sewer, you're relying on your gray tank, and that InstaHeat hot water heating system turns off whenever you pause. So if you're doing the Navy shower, you get in, you soap up, or you get in, you get wet, and then you soap up, you turn the water off to soap up, and then you turn the water back on to rinse off, you have to flush the cold water out of the lines every time you turn that thing off. Even if you throttle it back to just a trickle, the hot water heater shuts off. So we find that we're filling the gray tank way faster than we were in any other motorhome or any other RV we've had. This is our 7th RV. So it's not that we don't know what we're doing. Anyway, we don't care for that InstaHeat hot water heater, because we don't have enough gray tank for it. We're adapting. Of course, that's the name of the game to being mobile, is you adapt to the circumstances. But it's still, I don't care for it. I'd prefer having a tank. That way I didn't have to keep recharging. Let's go inside. The one we first purchased, when we first got Trudy, the auto level system was tilted to the driver's side, and I had that corrected. And now I realize why it was tilted to the driver's side, because the condensation from the air conditioner drips on the front door, the step, if it's not tilted a little bit to the driver. Start at the front. You can see we've had the beautiful picture window. Really love that. Now, since it's just the two of us and the dogs, we don't use that as the bed. We use it as temporary storage for stuff, and it kind of can be a catch-all if we're not mindful of it. As with any flat surface, here in the cab chassis, the only thing I'm not happy with is the monitor. On a sunny day, that monitor is, you can't see. It's so subject to glare. You can't, it's not even usable. But we do have the halo view with the camera on the pickup, so we can see behind us going down the freeway. Would be nice if the passenger seat was power with more adjustment options, but that wasn't an option for us, so yeah, we might do. Everything is holding up real well as far as the seat coverings go. Now, the cushions on the dinette, they don't seem to be real high quality foam pads, and they're starting to develop a memory of where we sit. It's cheap foam, what can I say? No issues with the air conditioning, especially since I did the internal modification that improved the airflow by 40%. This coach gets super cold. We don't need to upgrade to a 15 when we can get more air out of this than you can a 15. It's a 13.5. And if you don't know what I'm talking about as far as the modifications go, I'll put a link in the card right up there for that simple. It was such a simple modification to improve the RV airflow system. This is our second refrigerator. The first one was working just fine. When we took ownership, we found it was actually a crack on the inside of the freezer. They replaced the whole unit. I think we had the supply line to the ice maker has popped loose. We don't use the ice maker anyway, so there's a cutoff valve behind this drawer. I just turned that off. We have a new water pump. I just had the water pump put in. We were having a hammering noise. Whenever you turn the water on in the shower, or in the anywhere, pretty much it would hammer, but the shower was the worst. So the dealer solution was to put a new water pump in. I think it was more air in the lines, because I flushed the lines, blew out the lines to winterize it, and the noise got less when I recharged the system. Regardless, they gave us a new pump. I'm not complaining. Back here, there's been no real hiccups on anything except the water pump. Yeah, overall, very, very happy with it. Now, it has been brought to my attention, and you're not going to really be able to see it too well in the video. We've got a separation of the floor covering and the foundation. The floor covering is peeling up. Shortly after taking ownership, we realized that we had yellowing here, so both at the front and the rear, that was starting to turn yellow. And since then, I've noticed under the slide we're getting some yellowing. And when I mentioned the separation, the bubbling in the floor, he said, well, yeah, it's the glue. The service technician has seen that on a number of coaches, where that glue is yellowing the floor covering, and it's also releasing, allowing the floor covering to come loose. So we are filing a warranty claim, and I'll update you if and when we have new floor coverings. That's pretty much it. Our punch list was like 14 items long, but it took a whole year to get the parts for it. Overall, let's go back outside. It's too pretty a day to be inside. I'm at Fairfield Lake State Park, by the way. Look at this beautiful park. It's a beautiful campsite. This is my favorite campsite at Fairfield Lake. You can walk right down to the water. One of my favorites. There's like four of them that are super cool. It's a pull through, water access. It's only 30 amp. At number 81. Just roll in, push a button, and you're done. Actually, I have to push two buttons. I love this coach. We love it. Now, I'm not a big fan of the armless awning. Coach had an armless awning, and we had a detrimental experience with an unexpected gust of wind when we were in the Appalachian Mountains, and it took the awning and flipped it over. It was out of nowhere when the gust of wind hit. So we're just so gun shy, we don't ever extend that awning, because insurance paid for it, but we had to pay the deductible. So the awning works great, but we're just afraid to use it. I think that pretty well sums up. Haven't done a whole lot of modifications, you know, little stuff here and there to make life a little simpler, you know, hangers and storage stuff, adding shelves into the cabinets. We haven't had to do major modifications to it. We love Trudy. She's our rolling condo on wheels. That brings us to the end, but before we go, I sure appreciate y'all stopping by if you've stuck with me to this point. Hey, and if you've not already, I'd be very honored if you'd consider clicking on the subscribe button. And remember, hit that bell as well. If you found some value from this video, I'd appreciate you clicking on that thumbs up and sharing me across your social media. For those of you who have been following along, thank you. That is why I do what I do. That is why I'm out here today on this beautiful sunny day in this beautiful campsite. It's just so I can have a conversation with you. Thank you for that. And for my patrons, I am most grateful. You rock. All right, y'all come back now, you hear?